An awesome good morning to my dear students. How are you all? Fine? That's good. Dear students, before starting today's class, one thought for you. Failure will never overtake me if my determination to succeed is strong enough. Understand it? Beta, failure will never overtake if determination to succeed is strong enough. If you have thought to get success, then you can never fail. Failure will never overtake you if your determination to succeed is strong. Success will come to you. So let's start your class with this positive thought. So dear students, as per schedule your maths class is there. So chapter 8 money is going on. We will be continuing with that chapter only. I have told you in last class we have done some questions related to addition, subtraction, multiplication and division related to money, but actually money concepts I have told you that we will be discussing in next class. So today a few terms are associated with money related concepts like cost price, selling price, profit and loss. So I will explain you one by one. Dear students, whenever we go to the market, we notice that shopkeeper selling a lot of things. Does the shopkeeper sell things at the price at which he buys? Because if we are going to the market and we are purchasing something from the shop, so shopkeeper also purchasing material from something, but is it does the shopkeeper sell things at the price, same price at which he buys? Then what is the use of shopkeeping? Everybody wants to earn money, to earn profit. They are doing their business activities, but sometimes it happens there might be loss or there might be profit. So if the shopkeeper purchases anything and sells them at a higher price, then there is profit, and if he sells the item at lower price, then there is loss. How? So first of all, I will explain what is the cost price. Cost price is what? The price at which any item is purchased, bought, is called its cost price, and we can call it as CP. It is written as CP. CP stands for cost price. Now selling price, the price at which any item is sold, is called its selling price, and it is written as SP. SP stands for selling price. So basically, if we are purchasing the item, then that price is cost price for us. But if anyhow, whatever I have purchased, I have given to someone else and I am taking money in return, I am charging more than the price at which the purchase, that it is written as sales price. I have sold the item. Selling, that is known as selling price. It is written as SP. So when SP is greater than CP, then there is profit. Obviously, it is quite obvious. Suppose if I have purchased any item for 10 rupees and I am selling it for 15 rupees, then 5 rupees more I am getting. So that is profit for me, earning for me. So if selling price is more than the cost price, then there is profit. And how the profit is calculated? Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Next, but if I have purchased at a higher price and I am selling it at a lower price, I am getting less money, then there is a loss for me. So, opposite of first term, that CP is greater than SP, then there is loss. And how will we calculate? Loss is equal to CP minus SP. But if selling price is equal to cost price, not higher and not greater than lesser, then it means no profit or no loss. Again, I will take one example related to you and canteen. Suppose in school, you are going to canteen to buy any item. Suppose you bought a packet of chips for 5 rupees. And you come back to the class, your friend liked it and you have given it to him or her at 7 rupees. So it means 2 rupees more you got it, that the profit, that 2 rupees is profit for you. But if you are purchasing at 5 and giving at 5, then there is no profit, no loss. And but if you are giving to him or her at 3 rupees, then there is loss. So if you are getting a lower price, then there is loss. If you are getting a higher price, then there is profit. And how they are calculated? By subtracting from SP minus CP and CP minus SP. So dear students, now we will be solving some sums related to these concepts so that all of you can solve exercise 8.2. So let me take one or two more examples. Next is, before solving examples, I'll tell you one more thing. Overhead expenses. Additional expenses like transportation charges, repairing, labor charges, etc. They are called overhead expenses. Why we are taking it? Suppose you have purchased anything and you have spent some amount on its repair or on its labor, then it includes it in cost price. So let me explain you with the help of examples. First is a mobile phone costing rupees 1800 is sold at rupees 1600. Calculate profit or loss. Either profit is there or loss is there, then you have to think that what is there in profit or loss. Beta, a mobile phone costing rupees 1800 means that is cost price is equal to rupees 1800. Is sold at, sold means SP, selling price, 1600. So SP is equal to 1600. Now purchased price is 18, but selling price is 16. Selling price is less, it means loss is there. And formula to find out loss, CP minus SP. 1800 minus 1600 is equal to 200 is the loss. Next, one more example. A man buys a watch for rupees 240 and spends rupees 10 on its repair. A man buys a watch and spends some amount on its repairing. After that, he sold it for rupees 300. The profit or fine profit or loss. So, beta, whenever any expense is there, it is included in cost price. A man buys a watch means cost price of watch 240. And spent on its repairing. So repair amount is 10 rupees. So total cost price will be 240 plus 10. That is 250 rupees. After that he sold it. SP is equal to 300. Now he charged more price because he purchased at 250 and he is selling at 300. So profit is there. Profit is equal to SP minus CP. 300 minus 250 is equal to 50. So 50 rupees profit is there. So dear students, these were the examples to calculate profit or loss. And this is related to your exercise number 8.2. Try to solve exercise 8.2 in rough notebook. And in next class, I will send you solution key. Then you will match your answers. Thank you. God bless you.